Hi guys, Gray here. Time to summon up the points of this little wonder stick. And, well, to say that it surprised me is an understatement, because, well, I couldn't believe that a short bow could do, well, not much at all, but this really surprised me big time, you could say. So I've been giving it some points, and then I think about it again, and I change the points, and I think about it again. I think four or five times I've been changing them, but I've really been thinking hard, because, well, to be honest, I have a hard time believing myself that I'm giving it such a high point, because, but it really deserves it. It's just a perfect proper bow. It's just in a small package, so, and an immense amount of fun. That's just what this bow is. But not to forget that it is a lethal little stick too. So let's go on with it then. Number one, the looks and the build quality, it's absolutely astonishing. It's absolutely perfectly made, there's not a fault anywhere. And looking through the fiberglass, there's like some copper sparkling things. It's absolutely fantastic to look on. And the cocobola, and I think this is ebony on the limbs, and it's just amazingly well done, beautiful. So, and everything is so perfectly made, there's not a mark anywhere. So, as I said, that's a fiber. Speed, well, I don't give points for speed just because it's doing 220 feet per second. I just is it enough or not? And okay, it's not the fastest of them, it's a little slower, but still it's kicking around 170 feet per second, and man, with the carry it has, it's absolutely amazing. So I really can't give it no less or no more than a number four points. Because then we go to precision, number three, and it has some minor issues. It's a little nervous because it's short, but when I tweaked up the brace height, and I can't even hold with three fingers now with a bigger grip here without no problem. A few arrows flying a little strange, but still, when I'm holding high grip, every arrow 100% flies absolutely straight and really hits. It's just, it's a little nervous, the consistency isn't there. It's maybe a little bit hard to group three arrows exactly well, because I'd be comparing it with the Acadian, of course, and the Falco 4s and the White Wolf that I had done before. So it's a little nervous, consistency isn't perfect, but man, you see what I can do. Man, I can nail leaves from 35 meters. It's just incredible for this little stick. So I still gave it a 4. That is pretty amazing. So, because then we go down to, we're up to number 4, to trajectory and carry, and that really surprised the pants out of me, because man, we shot up that stump at 110 meters, and well, it flies like any bow I have, man. It shoots above every other bow. I mean, it's like it shoots 20 centimeters over, that's like 8 inches over every other bow I have. So the trajectory and the carry further distance is also just amazing. So that's full points. That's absolutely a fiber. Amazing. So, pointing, how it points, tilting, does it affect? Well, nothing affects more than any other bow. It's absolutely perfect. It's like every other bow, if you tilt it, no, it goes a little to the right, but it's down very close to your hand, so you, even if you twist it, you kind of got the arrow in the same position, as long as you just anchoring. So man, full point, 5 points there, absolutely. The One thing is number six here got a little lower points at hand shock, because it definitely has hand shock, but it just because it is a very light, it doesn't weigh anything, but still realize reflex deflex curve. And if I'm holding with a high grip, I can't feel it at all. It's just if I hold it like steady like this, I can feel the shock. But going up to a high grip, just kind of holding against, I just don't notice anything, to be honest. So, but still, just 3 points. So, and then we go up to seven, travel and easy packing. Well, it's not a two-piece or a three-piece, but it's so short, I can put it down in my car trunk. So, and it's so light to carry, so man, it's hard not to give it 4 points for that. So, okay, it could be, I don't know if it could be some issue, but I have it in a two-piece fly fishing rod sock that I put it in. So man, it doesn't take much more than that, so it could carry, probably, I don't know if it could even have it inside the aeroplane if you're flying with it. So, no, I think 4 is quite right. So then we go up to number 8, draw smooth and stacking. And well, I draw it up to 29.5 inches, felt like it was well enough. I didn't dare to draw it longer, but okay, I have a very high brace height, so if one would have a 30-inch, I mean AMO standard draw length, just lower the brace height and you can easily draw it up to 30 inches AMO. So, man, that's also just insane, just amazing to have this smooth draw. And it kind of has no stacking at all, because I'm going to tell you how I did it when I measured the draw length. I started at 26 and it gave 37 pounds. So it went up to 27, it gave 40 pounds, that 3 pounds increase. Then from 27 up to 28, it gave 44, so it went up 4 pounds. And the same from 28 to 29, up to 48 pounds. So I kind of stopped there, because I drew it up to 29.5, and that was around 49.50 pounds there. So, but that's just because I have a very high brace height. I have a pre-bend on it, quite heavy pre-bend on it. So, but that is just amazing. Like there's nothing wrong, nothing fault. It's just full points. That's a fiber, absolutely. So. And then I got number 9, spine critical, and I don't know, okay, every bow is spine critical with the arrows, but okay, very fast bows would be more spine critical, so this is kind of, that's not an issue, so like 4 points there too. So, and the noise, the sound it makes, gives when you shoot it, well, I can't hear anything, it's just amazing. It's like, man, Peter wondering if I shot those two arrows. Well, I did. You couldn't hear it. And, man, just incredible. So that's also a fiber, absolutely. So then we go to what is it best for? Is it target 3D or hunting? And target, well, it's a little nervous. The consistency isn't there like the bigger bows, and maybe not 3D. Maybe the most fun you can have with a bow. But consistency, there's a competing with 3D, maybe not, but just going out and having fun, oh yeah. But I would still put this one as a hunting bow, and especially just for fun, just having fun shooting archery. But hunting, tree stand, ground, blinds, man, this is going to be fantastic for that. So I would say mainly hunting and just have fun, archery, just shooting, guys. So fantastic. So what does that add up to? And I went back and looked at the Falco Force points, and it's the same. So this bow is as good as the Falco Force. Okay, it has some differences. Falco Force is more consistent, maybe more target 3D, but But the points are still the same, so man, that is incredible. I would never have thought that I'm gonna give this such a high point. To be honest, I didn't believe half of it, because I've seen films of the two guys are shooting, but I don't know about them. Maybe it's their first bow, and everybody who buys a bow thinks it's the best bow, it's wonderful and all that. You need to really shoot like 5 different custom bows to really understand what it's all about. So, but man, it's a proper custom bow, 100%. Absolutely amazing. So, not only your youth out there as a beginner's bow, tons of fun, and the price is just amazing, but I think every archer would appreciate this one maybe more than anything else. Because if you got that Ferrari, that Acadian, I really think you need to get one of these too, because man, this is a ton of fun. Absolutely fantastic. So just going out, thrashing some stumps and having some fun, and just knowing that I'm not going to shoot all 3 arrows in exact same place, but maybe I'm just going to have more fun. Because when you hit with a bow like this, that is so unforgettably fantastic feeling. So, because it feels like it's not possible, and still you do it over and over again, and man, that's just amazing. So I really understand why, like, Trophy Bow Marco likes this, because he knows his stuff. And well, I've been curious just because of him, because seems to know what he's talking about, and yes, he does, because this is a little gem. So guys, get one. Raise out.
See you in the forest, guys.